What's up? What's up? What's up? Okay, I'm outside this time. It is hot. And I'm probably gonna run out of power, so I'm gonna have to go back inside. But we'll see how this goes. Okay. I'm trying to think. Okay, the workshop that I wanted to do last weekend, but I couldn't do it because of the hurricane, was going to be about illusion tricks, is what I call it. Illusion tricks. Okay? And illusion tricks. Oh, wait a minute. Time. Wait, watch it. Okay. Illusion tricks are my way of describing a trick that looks like an illusion. Okay? So I'm gonna go over those. So here's the thing. I learned this from a cat called Ken Hill. And he does nunchuck stuff, right? So he's a big nunchuck dude. You can look him up on Instagram. He has a Facebook page where he covers nunchuck flow techniques. And anyway, I took that from him. I think it's called Flow Tricks, if you're gonna look him up on Facebook. But okay, so this is a trick that he does with nunchucks. And I was able to adapt it to beggary. And all it is you're using your thumb as a pivot point in the middle of the cord. And while you do that, you flip it, the cord does a rotation. It does a 180, I think is what it does. So yeah, you flip it this way. It happens really fast, but you're using the thumb as your pivot point. That's one illusion trick right there. Call that, I don't have a name. I don't know what he calls it. I should give it a name. But it's up for grabs. Someone can think of a name for that. This is an illusion pass, I guess. I don't know what else to call it. But it comes in handy if you're going to do two-handed transitions. If you're going to pass from one hand to the other. I mean, here's another thing, here's a tip. For people who are, when you're right-handed, okay, let's say you're right-handed. Yeah, pivot pass, I like that. When you're right-handed and you're, that would be your normal play style, I guess. If you use your left, then that's called switch, okay? I'm going to throw that in there because I'm going to be bringing that up. So if you are not, if you haven't like really experienced or experimented with your switch play, you shouldn't be afraid to do that because it's really good to do. And you'd be amazed at how the human body works. I broke my arm 8 years ago. And I'm right-handed. So I had to my body adapted. It's like I knew how to use my left hand for everything that I was, normal tasks that I would do with my right because it was out of commission. I broke the elbow. I have a bionic elbow now. Yeah. Oh, you gave me the ball. Here, take the ball, look at it. And so anyway, the point of all that is to let you know that you can learn left-handed switch tricks very easily. It's really not that hard. It seems like it's hard, but the hand remembers what, you know, the other hand does, and it can learn how to do it. What's up, Pepe? What's up? Well, where's the ball? You want me to throw it? You want me to throw it? Okay. So yeah, if you want to dabble in your switch hand play, don't be afraid to try it. Don't be afraid to do it. The brain is kind of funny, and you'd be surprised at how easy it is to learn how to do things on your switch side. So, that out of the way. That's a pivot pass, right? We already established that. What's another illusion trick? Okay, another illusion trick that I like to do is, it involves two hand play. Sharon, what's up? This is Nelly. I decided to be outside this time. Okay, so, another illusion trick that is two hand play involvement, and it's not that hard, I mean, anybody can really do it, is the slinky crawl. I'm just gonna give it a name. I gave it a name. Where's the ball? Can we throw it? That's Lila. And the big one back there, this one? That's Nelly. Whoa, Nelly. Okay, you have the ball? You good? You want it? Okay. That's Nelly. Okay, so a slinky, what did I call it? The slinky crawl. Okay, the slinky crawl is you're going to pass upward, okay, do an upward swing and catch it with your switch hand. Or you could do it the opposite way, it doesn't matter. But for right now, I'm gonna do it with your dominant hand is gonna start it. Your switch is gonna catch it. So you're gonna do upward swing and then catch it with your palm up, yeah? Then you're gonna release this bead. It's gonna swing that way, yeah? And when it does that, you just Here. When you release it, you're just going to swing it over. See what I did? You're gonna swing it over and catch it. So, swing up, release and catch. See that? Then release this hand, yeah? Catch it this way. See what I did right there? So that is your slinky crawl. And when you do it fast, when you do it in perfect order, and no dogs are in the way, knocking over the camera, it looks like this. It looks like, oh shoot. Now I got too nervous. Okay, it looks like this. Oh God, what do you want? Where is your... You're distracting me. Oh, here it is. Here's the ball. It looks like this. It looks like that. Did you see what I did? And I ended on a rebound. That's what I like to do. I'm all about the rebound. So, if you do it in a motion where you're moving your arms, it makes it look like it's crawling, like you're making it look like it's taking steps that way. You see what I did? So that's another illusion trick. I mean, it's not, I call it illusion because it looks crazier than what it is. It's really not that crazy. What do you want? Oh, you want the ball? What's another one I can show you? Holly! Oh. Okay, another one I can show you that's kind of like an illusion. And I think the older gentleman who put up a video, he was from the UK. He did a lot of this, and I've done it before. What's up, Richard? Now, this is also two-hand play, okay? Don't be afraid of two-hand play. I want to encourage two-hand play. Okay, so this one, I'm gonna call it, what does this look like? What should I call this? Propeller? Kind of looks like one. Or a fan? What do you guys like? What name do you like best? call it a fan. It's kind of like one. It's also, I think it's also a nunchuck trick around the world. Okay, I like that. Around the world, the snack. I don't know about that one. How many snacks for you? Oh, you made me say a bad word. I didn't bring any. I'm sorry. I'm a bad mother. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Okay, go over there. Go away. You want more food? I'm not having more. But all my food is belong to you. I know. I love you. I'm not prepared for this. Okay, so. What did we call this one? I can't remember now. Around the world. Okay, so around the world is two-hand play. You're gonna start with the dominant hand, yeah? I'm gonna get a little closer. I don't know if you can hear me. You start with your dominant hand. Doesn't matter what grip you hold it in. It's kind of like the same with the slinky crawl. It doesn't matter what grip you're... I always just use standard grip when I do this stuff. That's just more comfortable for me, but you can do it any grip. Okay, around the world. It's all gone. You ate it all. I have no more. I have no more. Okay, wait. Maybe I have a little bit more. Okay, that's it, and then I have to go get more from inside. I don't have any more out here. Okay. Where was I? Around the world. Okay, around the world. Starts with standard grip on your dominant hand. Yeah. So you have standard grip. You're going to pass, but in a horizontal swing. So it's coming towards your hand, okay? The slinky was from a bottom swing, but this is coming at you in a horizontal plane, okay? Oh, the one-handed trick is around the world? Okay, well, I don't know what to... I'm just gonna call this a fan. Okay, so... So when you do this pass, you're passing it forward, yeah, like towards your face, okay? You're catching it, then you're gonna release it with this hand, with your dominant hand, and you're gonna swing it in this motion. You see what I did? You're swinging it forward, but for this hand, it's backward, right? Because you're doing that kind of a thing. It's just what is it, a 360 rotation? So, okay, so you start over again. Dominant hand. Forward to catch. You know what? You're swinging it towards you. Okay, my bad. You're swinging it towards you. I think I should be at an angle. This is kind of hard to see. Okay, so swinging it towards you, spinning it this way, like continue that spin this way, and when it comes back around, this is the hand that's gonna catch it. Then you're gonna swing it this way, and you're gonna swing it that way. You just do it fast enough, and there you have it. That's a mega fan. I'm gonna call it the ultra fan. I don't know, there's probably a name for it, but I know, I haven't done my homework. We were attacked by a hurricane. I didn't have time to like research. Yeah, it's different. It's two-hand stuff that I'm showing you. I mean, it can help you because it'll get you out of your comfort zone if you've never done two-hand stuff. This is a good way to start. I'm showing you the early basics of it. So, what else can I show you? Illusion tricks. Okay, what I just showed you, mega fan, whatever but you can do it in an up and down plane, yeah? So, I think I showed you this one once before. I know I've done it before. I'm trying to remember where I showed it to you. But yeah, this is the same principle, but you're doing it up and down motion. And you can do it either way. You can do it up swing or down swing. You can do up swing or down swing. Aerial tricks. Okay, aerial tricks. I'll show you an illusion trick that involves an aerial. Throws the debris, lets it flip, and then they catch it, yeah? That's scenario. That's what you do. You usually throw it upward and catch the opposite bead, okay? That's a basic aerial. You throw it upward and catch the opposite bead. You can do that just to practice, see what it feels like. Keep it in play, keep it in motion. Oh, you found the other ball! Can you throw it? My dog's a fetcher. She likes to fetch. Oh, you brought it back. That's a good girl. Okay, so if you can do just basic aerials, you can do this illusion aerial I'm about to show you right now. So, in this illusion aerial I'm going to show you, you have to keep in mind that you are throwing the beggary up. It is going up and it is going to slightly start to spin. But instead of catching the opposite bead, you're gonna catch this bead. You're gonna catch the one that you just released. Yeah, you like that? I came up with that, that's fine. So I'll show you what it looks like. I don't know if you can see it very well, but see that? Did you see that? That's an illusion. What's the matter? Did you lose your ball? Go get it. Give me the ball. Give me the ball. I'll throw it to you. I'll throw it again. I'll throw it way out there. So did you see that? You want to see that again? Okay, so I hope I'm in frame. I don't know if I am or not, it's hard to see. Okay. There it is. I'm catching that same bead. So it's kind of, if you have monkey knuckles, are you familiar with monkey knuckles at all? I think I got bit by a mosquito in the face. Mosquitoes are bad right now, dude. They're in full force. It was sucking the life out of me. It was a mosquito. Oh. It was sucking the life out of my face. Why didn't you tell me I had a mosquito on my face? Gross. Okay. So anyway, that is the illusion aerial. It's kind of hard to keep it in frame and look at it. So I'm not gonna look at it. I'm just hoping it's in frame. So yeah, you can practice it. And if you're familiar with monkey knuckles, it reminds me of a monkey knuckle thing. Because what you're doing is it's spinning in the air, but before you let it complete the spin and before you grab the other ball and monkey knuckles speak, you would just catch that same ball that you just released. That's kind of trippy, and I know you don't see it a lot because nobody does it, because only I do it, and I just started doing it. So now, maybe you can do it too. So I showed you how to do it, okay. Oh, what's another thing I can show you? For the mosquitoes eat me alive. You found your rope, look.
okay.
What's another thing I can show you that's like an illusion type trick?
Oh, that was cool. I didn't even do that. That was you. That was all you.
My dog's a trickster.
Go there. Go over there. So I'm showing off.
Okay, let's do, let me see. What can I call this one? Anybody have any names for this one? I can show you how to do it. I don't have the name for it, though. looks like a Ferris wheel. Oh yeah, okay, well you're not gonna, it's not spinning at all, you're just letting it go and catching it in this case. Yeah. So this is just a release and catch aerial, and it doesn't even look like anything unless you really look at it. The back pedal, okay, back pedal. Back pedal is not too hard to get into if you don't already know how to do it. I guess the easiest way to do it is by mimicking what I'm doing. I guess I could explain it, but it's kind of like it's self-explanatory. You can see what I'm doing. That's the back pedal. I like to use my thumb to rest off of on my switch hand, and then I like to use my finger on my dominant hand. No, I take it back. I think I'm using both thumbs. Thumbs are the pivot point for this, for me, anyway. No, sometimes I use my finger. Sometimes I do one of these numbers while I'm doing it. I never know until I do it, so it's a little bit tricky to explain. But you have your dominant hand holding it standard, like I'm doing. That's a good way to start. You grab with your switch hand, right, when you're going to shoot somebody. Oh, that's another one right there. That's a slingshot, I call. I do that with astrojacks. But I'm supposed to catch it, like that. It's like you shoot it out. Oh, shoot out. Okay, here's another one. And I do this quite a lot, but I don't know if it's caught on. I don't think it has. A shootout is where you wrap your finger with your dominant hand, yeah? And then you shoot it out. And when you shoot it out, you're going to catch it with your other hand. These are all pretty much two-hand transition tricks. Yeah, come back, Tomo. You might learn something interesting. So yeah, okay, so this comes in handy when you're going to go into switch tricks. That's a good transition, and I don't see anybody doing it because I invented it, and I'm the only one that does it. And I'm not one of the cool kids. So, you know, I don't know. I need to make tutorials. I need to do that. Oh, here's another one. Okay. Everybody right now is all about... Yeah, I'm going to save, yeah, this is totally going to be saved. You can go back and watch this later. If you have to go, if you can't stick around and watch it right now, it's all good. Let me see. Everybody's all about the bead rolls right now. Like, I'm trying to figure out what else to cover for illusion tricks. But I do a different set of tricks than the normal player does. So you're not going to see me doing... like all the fancy stuff that the new school kids do, because I'm old school and I kind of do my own things that I came up with. But they're not, you know, terribly bad. They're fun to do. Yeah, I hope more people, right, Tomo. I want more people to get into two-hand stuff. Like, everybody's all about, bead rolls right now, yeah? A bead roll is when you, like, roll the bead hand from one finger like that to another. You can't see it because it happens so fast, right? that's what's happening. So when you're doing that, I started kind of messing around with it the other day on how we can make bead rolls a two-handed thing, and that's what I came up with. You see what I'm doing right there? And that kind of looks fancy for if you're gonna do a transition into a combo transition, a two-handed bead roll. And it's just turning the beads in a clockward motion, making rotations around those fingers, but you're just doing it so fast that you can't see it. Yeah, but those are two-handed bead rolls. I came up with that just the other day. Yeah, I was waiting for Domino's Pizza. They only had thin crust, and I was like, you know what? I'm gonna figure out these bead rolls for two-hand play, because I can already kind of do them for one-hand play, but I only do them when it comes to a weave. I can do it with mid-grip. That right there was a bead roll. I can do it with standard grip. That right there was a bead roll. It's hard to see because I'm like in the dark right now. I'm gonna move it to the light and see if I don't run out of Wi-Fi. But I think I'll still have Wi-Fi. Pizza, baby, pizza. You gotta do the pizza thing. Okay, let's move this. Let's move this to the light. Try to position this in a place where my dogs will not knock this over. But I want to kind of be in the light, okay. And now I have low battery. Oh yeah, I want to go to Jersey, dude. I went to New York, but I never got to go to Jersey. I think I went to the Jersey airport to leave New York. That was back in 2009. And yeah, I spent all my time in Brooklyn. Oh yeah, there's mosquitoes out here, dude. They're attacking me right now. I'm gonna head this back inside. So, bear with me. I'm very fragile. I'm fragile. I don't like mosquitoes biting on me, and it takes all the fun out of my play. And I'm reaching my 30-minute time. So, actually, you know what? Okay, no, I'm not gonna go inside now. I changed my mind. I'm not gonna go inside. I'm just gonna stand for a minute and be away from the grass. Because the grass is what's doing it to me. That's where all the mosquitoes are. Okay. Wait, why are you hogging the stream? Why is it my time already? Is it already time? Because by my watch, I have 28 minutes. That means I have like two. I have two more minutes left. yeah, be quiet. Shut up, Mitch. Yeah, I have 28 minutes here. 28 it says on my thing. Oh. It's 30 minutes. I set the rule. I'm not going to break it. I'm keeping track. Okay, what's the next thing I can show you? Okay, two-handed bead rolls. Oh, the crank. We have time. I have 1 minute left. I will show you the crank. Okay, so the crank is an act of just rotating your hands, yeah? Rotating your arms in a cranking motion. You want to do it maybe just once. You don't have to overdo it. You want to do just like one full rotation, and there you go. And that's the crank. So these were illusion tricks. I hope you learned something. I hope you enjoyed it. I got bit by a mosquito for it, so I bleed for you so that you will learn. Okay, I'm out.